Should you use sucralose? Should you take it? It's in Quest bars, it's in lots of popular products. Holy Grail. It's an engineered sugar, let me show you. It bypasses your small intestines. The reason it works is because caught up in all these lights and cameras. But look what that shit did to Hammer. God damn it, I like it. Bright lights entice. Hey everyone, it's Christine with Gage Girl Training, and today I'm bringing you a video on food science talking about the differences between some popular sweeteners. I'm going to be talking about sucralose, which is commonly known as Splenda. I'm going to be talking about stevia, and I'm also going to talk about my personal favorite calorie-free sweetener of choice. So let's get started. Alright, so let's talk about sucralose for a moment. Sucralose is also known commonly as a commercial product known as Splenda. It's a very popular product that's out on the market today. And the reason for products like this is because people like their food to be sweet, sweet like milkshake, diabetic shock sweet, but still get away with having no calories. That's why like the diet product market is so huge. And I wanted to talk about sucralose. What is it? Is it safe? Should you be taking it? And what you actually need to know about it. So the first thing you want to know about sucralose is this. Number one, sucralose has been around for at least a good 60 or so years. Yeah, a good 60 or so years. It was invented in the UK by a company called Tate & Lyle. It's in commercial production today. So there is a lot of safety data on this product. It's been on the market for a very long time. You know it as Splenda. And it's a calorie-free sweetener. What you may not know about it is sucralose is 600 times the sweetness of regular table sugar. Again, let me repeat that. 600 times the sweetness of sugar with no calories. How the hell do scientists make that happen? Let me show you. So this is what the sucralose molecule looks like. The thing that is unique about sucralose is this. It's made up of carbon, hydrogen, and oxygen, so that piece of it is organic. The piece of it that is not, though, is the fact that it has these chlorine atoms. So what sucralose has that makes it calorie-free are these chlorine atoms. There is chlorine in your calorie-free sweetener. So what does that mean? When you eat something that has this ingredient in it, it's in Red Bull, it's in a lot of gum, it's in a lot of calorie-free products, low-calorie products that want that strong sugary taste without the extra calories from sugar. When you ingest this, your body sees the chlorine, actually it sees it as a poison. And because your body sees chlorine as a poison, it bypasses your small intestines and is excreted directly through your body because your body's like, oh shit, this is poison, I need to get rid of this. Red alert. So that is why those calories from sucralose are not broken down and used in your body for energy, because your body sees it as a toxin, it pushes it out through your body, and that's why it's not used. Now, here's the question. Should you use sucralose? Should you take it? It's in Quest bars, it's in lots of popular products. Now, if you are one of those people that have been eating very sweet candy bar-like foods for a long, long time, it may be a good place for you to start if you want to move in a lower calorie route, but like you just know yourself, you know you're not gonna be able to stick to a plan unless the food tastes good. But the reality is, you guys should know that the reason it works is because there's a toxin in there that your body is saying, this should not go through my body. So does it work? Does it function? Yes. Is it safe? That's questionable, and I think that's up to the individual to decide. I'm just here to present you the information of what it is, what's in it, and how it works. And I think it's up for you to decide if that's what's right for you. The other thing I wanted to talk about is stevia. So stevia has been really popular. It's also a calorie-free sweetener as well. It's from the stevia plant. It comes in a leaf. It's very native of South America, I believe. And the sweetener in stevia is actually called Reb A. It's short for ribodioside A. Now, the degree of how much that Reb A has been extracted is going to depend on how it tastes. I'm personally not a huge fan of stevia just because I believe it has a little bit of like a licorice aftertaste. There are some good products that have stevia, but it's really more of a blend of some stevia with a little bit of cane sugar, which makes it taste a little bit better in my opinion. But stevia is this molecule right over here, stevia glycoside. This is what it looks like. You guys can see it's just made up of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. There's no funky craziness to it. So do you like the taste? I would say it's nowhere near as tasty as sucralose. I mean, sucralose in my opinion is like scientific crack cocaine, because it's just it's an engineered sugar. It's 600 times the sweetness of sugar. Now stevia, it's more natural, it's a lighter sweetness, it is calorie free as well. Does it taste as good as sucralose? In my opinion, this is my opinion only, no. But is it more natural? Does it contain any toxic ingredients that you would want to be concerned about? No. So that's up for you to decide. There's one more sweetener that I didn't draw on the board that I do want to make mention of, which has been my happy medium personally, and that is monk fruit. Monk fruit, you can actually buy it in packets called monk fruit in the raw. You can find it under a lot of different brand names, but monk fruit is a mongroside, and it comes from the ingredient called Lo Han Guo. It is native of Asia. It's, to me, that's probably like the sweet spot, no pun intended, where it actually tastes very, very good. It's a clean taste to it. It has a very low glycemic index to it, and it makes your food taste good without adding a lot of calories, without adding a lot of garbage, and it doesn't have an aftertaste. So these are just some thoughts from Christine here at Gage Girl Training on artificial sweeteners, calorie-free sweeteners, and just some facts to present to you on what to decide. So if you need more information on how to make a custom meal plan, go to gagegirltraining.com, and please subscribe to this YouTube channel. Take care and have a great day.